Hi students, today we are going to discuss about Topper IIT NEET Foundation. In the Topper IIT NEET Foundation, 6th class biology. In 6th class biology, so we are already completed the first lesson and then coming to the second lesson. So what is the second lesson? Food components. So we are already discussed different components which are eating as a food material and which is mainly important for the energy and for health purpose. So that food components are mainly includes carbohydrates, proteins, lipids and fat materials and also some of the fiber materials and minerals also, vitamins, minerals and water. These are all comes under the different food materials which are eating as a food, okay, nutrient sources. So in that, what is the purpose of the carbohydrates, proteins and in which resources they are high amount will be available. These are we are discussed in last class. So then coming to the another important one. So last class we are discussing about minerals. What are they? Minerals. So in that minerals, there are some of the minerals are required for our body in large quantities and they are called as macro minerals or macronutrients and some of them are required in very small quantities and they are called as micronutrients or micro minerals. These micronutrients are required in very small quantity and they are very essential for our body also. So that like that nutrients are, for example, we know about iodine. So iodine is very important for the different metabolic activity and functioning of the thyroid gland, because the thyroid gland releasing thyroxine and T3 T4 hormones are very helpful for metabolism and growth also. So during that metabolic activities, the iodine is very important. So iodine is taken as a food material in the form of the food material, iodized salt form also we are taking. And from the seafood materials, whenever we are eating seafood materials, they are containing high amount of the iodine. Then coming to the another important mineral is calcium. What is the another important mineral? Calcium. So this calcium is very high amount in whenever we are eating meat, chicken or egg or pulse varieties and milk. These are all are containing high amount of the calcium and most of our body means 1.5 to 2% of our body constituents are mainly containing this calcium, made organs. For example, most of the calcium is present in our bones. These are very useful for our movements. Whenever we are moving any organ or whenever we are moving from one place to the another place, this calcium is very important. So, and then another important one is whenever we can take lesser amount of the calcium in the food material, then it leads to a problem called as osteoporosis or osteomalacia and rheumatic arthritis problem also. Due to the deficiency of this calcium or due to the low levels of the calcium, the bones will be somewhat weaker and they are very highly flexible in nature and they'll be broken up and there will be some problems will be arising. And another important mineral which is taken as a food material, which is taken from the food material, that is called as iron. So iron is one of the most important constituent in hemoglobin. Where? Hemoglobin. Because in our body, the fluid material which is transforming from one place to the another place is called as blood. So the blood is in red color. why the blood is in red color means because of the presence of the hemoglobin pigment. So where this hemoglobin pigment is present in the blood. So this hemoglobin containing hemoglobin is contained two parts. One is heme part and second one is globin part. Globin part is nothing but protein content, and heme part is containing iron material. What is that? Iron material. So this iron containing heme is very important for the oxygenation, means during the respiration, whenever we are taking the oxygen that is from the environment, that is enter into our body and mix with this hemoglobin, and this hemoglobin is transfer this oxygen into every part of our body containing cells. So that's why this hemoglobin is very important for oxygenation of our body. So for that purpose, this iron is very important. So another important material which is present in our body is called as water. So total of our body, most 90% of our body constituents are containing water content. So for example, if you take any cell, in the cell also, besides this cell organelles, mostly 90% of the protoplasm, means the protoplasm which is the living material present inside the cell membrane. So this protoplasm is a living material and it is containing the cytoplasm and nucleus. Cytoplasm and nucleus both are together called as protoplasm. In this, the cytoplasm is containing most fluid material. That fluid material is made with approximately how much amount of the water? 90% of the water. So without water in our body, any metabolic activity is can't done in our inside of our body. So taking water in more constituents only, our body will be perform all the metabolic activities properly. So what is meant by metabolism? So whatever the reactions which are occurs in our body are called as metabolism. So means, for example, whenever we are eating food material, the food material is undergoing digestion process in our body. So that is one of the metabolic activity. Or during the respiration, whatever the oxygen we are taking from the environment, that is transported to every part of our body. That is one of the metabolic activity. And reproduction, like in all organ system performing functions, there are so many number of reactions, chemical reactions are occurring. So during that, several metabolic components are synthesizing and several components are undergoing breakdowning, and during that breakdowning process, whatever the energy is required for that organism function, that is released from that metabolic food material. So this the protoplasm, so most of our body is containing water as a one of the, so that's why only water is a universal solvent. And whenever we are taking the food water, whenever we are taking food material, with that food material we are taking little bit amount of water also, because the water is mixing with the food material and it easily allows that food material into our body, means inside of our body. Whenever we are swallowing or whenever we are mixing the food with the saliva, and during the enzymes which are released inside of our body, most of our body fluids are containing mostly high amount of the water. And this water is very helpful for the movement of food material easily, means water is acts as a one of the lubricant material. This lubricant material easily allows the water from one part of the body to the different parts which are present in our body. And also whenever in the large intestine, whatever the food material is digested, after that reabsorption will be occurs, then the movement of the undigested food material easily into the outside of the environment means for the elimination of the waste material from our body also done with the help of the water. Whenever we are taking excess amount of the water, then we are relieved from constipation and to remove the undigested food material from our body is also easy process. It will be occurs, and during the swallowing of the food material also, whenever we are taking more liquid quantities, then it is easily allows that food material into our body. Whenever we are not taking sufficient amount of the water means, then our body is suffering with a problem called as constipation, dehydration problem. And during this dehydration problem, our body is requires more and more amount of water, and this water will be not sufficient for our body metabolic activities. So that's why whenever we are taking the water, they are required in a very sufficient quantities, then only our body. And also whenever we are eating the food material, with the help of the food materials, we are taking some fiber containing food materials also. For example, if you take guava fruit, or if you take some of the fiber containing food material, for example cucurbita, or for example ridge gourd you are taking, or bitter gourd you are taking, they are containing some amount of the food material. So these fibers are also easily allows the undigested food material from one part to the another part. And during the peristaltic movement, whenever the food material is moving from one part to the another part also, this fiber content is easily allows the food material into from one part to the another part. So for that purpose, and in our body the fluid material is present for the transporting of the nutrient materials or vitamins or minerals or any of the material which is transporting from one part to the another part is mainly with the fluid material. So like blood and lymph, etc. So this blood and lymph are also containing most of the amount of the water. So our all metabolic activities mostly depends on water only. So that's why daily take sufficient amount of the water for our health purpose. Whenever we are taking sufficient amount of the water, that water is helpful for all the metabolic activities functioning in our body. Balanced diet. Balanced diet means whenever we are taking the dietary components as a food material during the nutrition, so then we are taking different varieties of the food material like carbohydrate containing sources, protein sources containing food materials, or lipid materials, or some amount of fibrous containing food materials, and some amount of whatever the food material which is required for our healthy purpose, all are taken as a diet. So whenever we are taking daily the food material, but that food material must and surely it should contain some of the nutrient materials, because that nutrient materials are giving health to our body, good health to our body, or proper maintenance of our body. Means whenever the metabolic functions in our body will be occurs properly, then our body will become health, and it also maintain all the functions which are occurs in our body. So some of the food material with carbohydrate, little bit protein sources, lipid sources, and some of the roughage material, whenever we are taking in right quantities, sufficient quantities, then only we will become health. So for example, if you take age of the persons, means there in the human being there are children will be there, and some adult people will be there, and some younger people will be there, and somewhat middle aged members are there, and old age members are there. So for all the ages, is the food material required to their body is same only? No, it is somewhat different from one age to the another age. Because for example, if you take children, they'll take some of the materials in high quantities and some of the materials in low quantities because of the digestive capability of that person. And whenever you are taking adult healthy person, then they are taking most high amount of food materials for their health purpose. So like for different age people, different nutrient diet materials. So that's why only whenever we are taking the food material daily, so we can prepare one chart. In that chart, we are in that chart containing food materials are contain sufficient amount of the carbohydrate, protein, whatever the nutrients which are required for the sufficient or essential quantities, that will be present in that particular diet. So like that, we are preparing a chart basing on the nutrients we have to take in the form of food material. Then follow that chart, then it is easy, it is giving good health for us. So we are eating daily so many types of different food sources also, like pulses containing food materials and groundnut containing food sources, soya bean containing, and Bengal gram, green gram, or so something moong dal, like and some of the fermented means idli, dosa, and some chapati, rotis, pulkas, and some of the pizzas, burgers, and some of the combination of the materials, means for example rice with vegetables, or rice is mixed with some dal items or pulses materials, like some of the fruit materials. These are all we are taking as the food material in required quantities. So these are all are giving some balanced food to our body. So food having the all quantities which are essential for, which are required for which are required to our body, that diet is called as balanced diet. So whenever we are taking the balanced diet daily, then we are maintaining a proper health for our body. So the essential, all the essential quantities containing food material we are taking as a food material, that is called as balanced diet. So eating required quantities and a right kind of food material to our body is very very important for health purpose. Without taking the balanced diet, or for example whenever we are taking the vegetables, so we are preparing a curry, so whenever we are taking potatoes, or we are taking any vegetable curries. So after peeling that vegetables, then we are washing in the water, means some of the vitamins, minerals which are present in that peel, or which are present inside the in that fruit, will be lost in that water whenever we are washing with the water. Then there is no sufficient quantity of the vitamins and minerals are not available for our body. And for example, some of the vitamins are lost whenever we are heating that food material. For example, vitamin C, most of the vitamin C is available in citrus containing fruits, means somewhat sour fruits like guava fruit you take, or lemon, oranges, like these fruits are containing high amount of vitamin C quantities. Whenever we are heating that high amount of vitamin C containing food materials, whenever we are heating, then the vitamin quality, means the vitamin capacity or whatever the nutrient, the vitamins are lost in that food material. Then whenever we are eating that food material, there is no sufficient quantities of the vitamins are not available for our body. So that's why washing the vegetables after peeling, or whenever heating the food materials, sufficient some of the particular food materials with the help of heat is also not done. And whenever we are taking rice, so we are cleaning or we are washing that rice. So if two times washing is enough for rice, but some of the persons are doing more times washing that rice because of the means more cleanness they will be preparing. So during due to that more cleanness, they are washing the rice with many times. So washing rice with many times means whatever the required materials, whatever the vitamins, minerals, or whatever the carbohydrate sources which are present inside the rice will be lost with that of water. So then whatever the food we are cooking that is not containing proper vitamins, minerals, and proper carbohydrates also, then we are eating that food material is not giving sufficient diet for our body. So that's why in some cases, whenever we are washing or excess means after peeling we are washing the vegetables. For example, some of the persons, if you observe, after peeling potato, they are cutting them into some pieces. So that pieces they are throwing in water and washing that pieces, and they are going for preparing the curry. So then there is no proper containing carbohydrate or proper vitamins and minerals which are present in potato. They will be washed with that water. So whatever the remaining material that is not containing proper amount of the food material also. So like that actions we are doing with our during the taking the food material is not giving proper diet for our body. Taking essential quantities of the nutrients to our body is called as balanced diet. So during the food material preparation and curries preparation, or for example, forever excess washing, or after cutting the pieces they are washing with the, or whenever the unwanted whatever the fruits which are containing vitamins and mineral sources, we are washing or we are heating that food material, then also they will be lost with the that proper materials. Then if you are eating that, they are not giving any diet which are not giving proper diet for us. So then lead to the some of the problems to our body, means there are several deficiency disorders will be occur to our body. For example, if you are taking the food material, so if any person is not taking a proper diet, means if any person's body is not getting proper vitamin or proper mineral or proper nutrient to their food material, then that person is suffering with something problem, means something disease, like nail discoloration, or skin is not properly growing, or growth is not will be occurs properly, or there is something deficiency will be occurs, or something skin problems or bone problems, like any deficiency in nutrient material during the taking of the food material is lead to the deficiency problem in that body. For example, if any person is not taking proper protein diet, then also that person is suffering with some hair discoloration or skin discoloration, or proper means some patches are present on the skin body, or proper means the body building means something weakness will be appears in that body, that all are appears in that persons. So that's why if the diet is deficiency with the carbohydrates or protein, then a long time the growth of the persons or the metabolic activities which are occurs in that person will be not held properly, then the person is suffering with some deficiency problem. For example, if any person is not taking proper vitamin content, then they are suffering with a different problem. For example, if any person is not taking vitamin A not properly, means they are not taking the food with vitamin A containing food material, then the persons are suffering with a problem called as eye problems, means loss of vision will be occurs. So due to the loss of vision means there is no proper sighting, means long sight and short sightedness in early ages will be occurs during the vitamin A deficiency. And some of the persons during the vitamin A deficiency, they are suffering with night blindness also, means night time they will not see any body or any object also. And some of the persons are, the persons are not taking proper amount of vitamin C, and the body will be suffering with problem called as scurvy. Scurvy means there is a skin rashes on the skin will be appears. So in that persons there will be bleeding gums, means in between the teeth there will be gum, mean connecting material will be there, in that the bleeding will be coming, or wounds are not healing proper time, means whenever any wound is formed, blood is oozing from that wound long time. So there is no proper wound healing capacity in that persons also we will appears. And if persons are not taking proper vitamin D, and means then that person is suffering with a problem called as rickets problem. Rickets means it is related to some bone disorders, means bones are not grown properly, and they are also very delicate manner they will be appears in that persons. So due to the bones weakness, they will be vitamin D persons will be occurs. And in some of the persons, calcium will be in lesser amount, means then bones and tooth decay, means there will be bones will be weakly formed, and they will be easily broken by some activities, means whenever they are weighing some heavy objects, or they are properly maintaining their growth, means then easily the calcium is less, means bones are very weak in nature and easily groans. So weak bones and tooth decay and impairment in the movement of the legs also will be appears in the calcium deficiency. And whenever the person is not taking proper amount of iron, means then the person is suffering with a problem called as anemia. Anemia means less amount of hemoglobin content will be appears in that persons. So anemia will be occurs, means some respiratory problem and weakness will be appears in that persons. And some of the in some condition, iodine will be taken in less amounts, means there will be a problem in the growth. So growth is not proper, and that problem is called as goiter problem will be appears. Goiter problem will be appears. appears and proper growth will be absent in that person. So that's why due to the deficiency of any proper materials in the diet means the persons are suffering with different deficiency diseases. So takes equal essential quantities of the food material whenever we are taking the food, then that is called as balanced diet. So this is about food components. So next class we are going to discuss about remaining topic. Okay, thank you.